Time to go. Oh, yeah.
Bring you back something from L.A.?
Yeah, how about a deck for out back? Oh, we need some more beta tapes for the video camera.
No, I mean for you.
You. Home real soon.
Hey, wanna take the kids skiing up at Brundage tomorrow?
Oh, let's just go fishing at the lake, okay? It'll be easier on my head.
You know, you've been having too many of these. What did Dr. Scott tell you?
He had to cancel due to some emergency. But I'm going in on Monday at 11 o'clock for some tests.
Wow!
Mom!
Dad! Dad, come on! I'm...
Come
it's
on! It's right back!
Okay, sweetie.
I'm pretty sure it's on the beginning of our house building tape, darling.
Okay.
How was the party?
Okay, I guess.
Guess? Didn't you have fun?
Not really.
What do you mean, not really?
I just didn't.
Out with it, young man.
I don't really want to be there, but I had to wait for Dan's mom to pick us up.
Why didn't you call us? We would have picked you up.
We've always told you before. You leave where you feel you don't belong.
Well, some of the other kids were... Oh, never mind.
Jess, You've always been able to talk to me before. What happened?
Well, some of my kids are drinking and smoking, and the older ones are doing drugs upstairs. Sandy and I just hate that crap.
Listen, from now on, you leave when you feel you don't belong. You too, Sally, okay?
It doesn't matter what anyone else thinks or does.
You have a good head on your shoulders. If you feel something is wrong, you get up and leave. Or you give us a call and we'll give you a ride home. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah, that's it. Remember, leave where you feel you don't belong, okay? Got that? I guess he's all alone in the world, honey. He must be freezing. It still gets pretty cold at night.
See how important it is to be a close family? You'll never be alone like that as long as your brother's with you. That's why we had two of you.
Dad, can I give him a space blanket?
Can I give him some food? He looks hungry and unhappy.
Okay, sweetheart. Why don't you give him this? Give him one of these, too.
Are you all right?
Mom, are you okay?
Yes. Yes. Oh, I'll be all right in a minute. I just got a little dizzy. It's these headaches again.
The body of a 10-year-old Priscilla Randolph has been found this morning in an old abandoned sewer pipe. She is the second victim in this latest bizarre child murder case.
God, how can anybody be that sick? Peter, did you hear that?
Yeah.
Walker told News Center
7 the
latest psychological probability
stay away from strangers.
Indicates that the child murderer is a homicidal pedophile with extreme violent tendencies.
Kids, help your father put away the ski gear.
Oh, Mom.
Mom, we're tired.
You always get tired when it comes to work.
Hi, guys. Come on, help Cooper. Help. He needs help with his hair stuff. Come on.
Can I go shoot?
Sure.
Ugh.
Why can't I go with you, Dad?
Well, because I need you here to take care of your little sister and your mom. Besides, you have school. And it's only the first meeting with the agent and the people who are commissioning the artwork for the new building in L.A. Okay?
But I don't like it when you go away. Mommy doesn't either.
I know. But we all have to make sacrifices, dear.
But I want to...
But nothing. We still have to make a living, right?
Yeah, but I wanted to go with you.
Listen. We'll all go together to the unveiling ceremony. Deal?
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Okay. Look at this stuff. We'll have this up here. We'll stash it over there. That way, in case of an emergency, we have it. That's good survival gear.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. I'm starved. See this.
Okay, what'd you do?
Nothing.
It's taking you this long and you haven't done anything?
All right, it worked! Sally, get out of my stash!
Damn it, Jess, turn off that siren!
No, I can't find.
That's no reason for you to touch mine!
I thought you
back! I mean, no!
Sally, unplug it!
Ah, thank God. It's all right.
I wish you weren't leaving tomorrow.
Don't worry, it'll only be for a couple of days.
I'm sorry, Mommy. Don't cry.
Yeah, Mark, give me a complete background history on Bart Williams, John Johnson, and Bill Craig. I need that as soon as possible.
You're right.
Okay. Oh, here, Sarah.
Ah, guy's really sick.
Okay, 3 o'clock. Good enough. So, what do you think, David?
Yeah, I can see it.
Good.
Okay, run with it, darling.
I will. Oh, by the way, Peter's in town for the Shapiro sculpture project. I told him to stay at the beach house, okay, honey?
Yeah, of course.
Good.
Hi, guys.
Oh, there he is.
What's
now.
Going on?
Well, hey, how's it going, Mountain Man?
Great.
Hey, buddy, I gotta run. Julie, see if you can get this man to have some dinner with us tonight.
You got it.
How is my favorite agent?
Oh, overworked and underpaid, but happy.
Okay.
I stole that.
Uh-oh.
Caught.
Beach house is yours. We watch our footprints here in the sand as the waves now wash them away. All that remains are the traces of my mind as we find harmony in the throw of the tide. And I know hi, Peter. We've got good news for you. The board decided to go with your ideas.
Oh, that's great.
Hey, your ideas are brilliant. I always feel such power from your work, Peter.
Well, thank you. That's very kind, Mr. Shapiro, and very good for the ego, I might add, huh?
The attorneys are drawing up the contracts, so we can meet at their offices tomorrow. Let's say about 11. Then we can all have lunch, okay?
Sounds great.
Okay.
I think I can manage that.
Yeah. Oh, you better manage that.
Listen, you think I could use your phone? Because I want to share the good news.
Of course. Okay. Come with me.
Bye. Well, so I'll get him started on those sculptures right away.
Hi, sweetheart. Kids home from school yet?
Not yet.
What did Dr. Scott say?
Well, he won't know anything till the tests come back. But at least he gave me something for the pain. Yeah. Hey, how was your meeting?
Absolutely great. Guess what? You can have your deck and your new barn. The one you always wanted.
Oh, I have to go pick up the kids.
I'll call tonight, say hi to the kids, and, I love you. Bye.
I miss you.
welcome.
Thanks. Hi, Jake.
Hi, honey. How's Boise?
Don't ask.
How about tonight?
No, Jake, not tonight. I'm just too busy.
Okay, call you later.
Mr. and Mrs. Berg?
Like to adopt.
What made you wait so long? There are a lot of other couples ahead of you, and
considering your age, I must advise you that it is our policy to find younger couples for our children. But we thought that if we...
12 years ago, we lost our son and his family in an accident. We're just now ready to start over again. We just recently sold our business, and we're really quite well off, as you can see.
And now we have the time and the love to give to these children.
I have to tell you, I don't think there's much of a chance of adoption in your case.
But I'll see what I can do. Please, we can give them a lovely home.
Yes, yes, I understand.
Come on, Mama.
She isn't getting up.
I'm on my way. Yes, I'll charter a plane. I'm calling Dr. Scott. So help your mother. Leave the front door open, okay? That's right. Leave it open for the doctor. He'll be there. And I'll be home in a few hours. You got that?
Okay, help Mommy and wait for the doctor. Okay, I'll take care of my sister. Okay, please hurry. I'm afraid.
I'll be home real soon.
Okay, I love you. Mommy, Daddy's on his way.
Sally.
can we become? I want you two to be very brave right now. Take care of yourself and your father while I'm gone. Stay together as a family.
Where are you going? I want to go with you.
Shh. And don't cry. I'm going to a beautiful place where love and peace exist.
Don't worry, you'll be okay. You can't die.
Only the body dies, remember. But your spirit will never die. As long as you think of me in your heart, I will be with you always. And with you. I love you.
Take it easy, Michelle. Everything will be all right. Take it easy. Easy, girl. Easy, easy. Easy now. Come on, just hold still, Michelle. I know. I know.
Easy. Your mother's very, very sick. I think it's an aneurysm, so I'm taking her to the hospital immediately. On the way over, I called an ambulance. It'll be here in a few minutes. Now, take it easy. I know, I know. You'll be all right. Easy. Easy.
I can't feel my hands.
Hello? Easy. Easy. Dr. Scott, it's the sheriff.
Okay.
Sally.
This is Dr. Scott, Jacob.
Mrs. Davis is seriously ill. Can I help you?
There's been a plane crash. I'm afraid Mr. Mommy? Davis was killed on impact.
No.
Mommy!
Dear God. Come on, baby. It's okay.
Now we are. Your mom's in a safe, comfortable place.
They still haven't recovered Peter's body. So you see, Kathy, both parents died practically at the same time. Jeff still isn't convinced that his father's dead. He thinks you're just trying to take his sister away from him.
That's ridiculous. Too bad they don't have any other family. I'll do everything I can for them, of course, but, you know, it's really tough to place older kids like the boy. I have no problem with the little girl. We found a nice couple for her.
And our office found temporary placement for the boy also.
That's terrible. They're good children. They truly love each other and need each other very much. You just can't rip them apart like that. Good Lord. I wish I could take them, but I'm just never at home.
I'm sorry. I'll do all I can. They do seem like lovely children. I'm sure we'll find a proper home for both of them. It may take a little time, but we'll keep working at it.
Okay.
Sally, Jess, come on.
Colder, nice to see you again. I believe the papers are ready to sign. May I have the papers for Miss Colder, please? Just right. Thank you very much.
Now, children, I want you to listen carefully. I've arranged for you to go back to school starting Monday morning. Your home and all your family possessions are being liquidated and given to that trust at the bank. Now, unfortunately, at this time, I've not been able to find a home for both of you together, so, what is it?
I need to go.
Go? Go where?
No, go.
No!
He has to go to the bathroom.
It's down the hall until your left and hurry up. Yes. Oh, send them right in. Sally, the new foster parents are on the way in. I want you to be nice to them. Do you understand? And don't worry, darling. I'll see you get together with your brother soon.
Miss Colder, you need to take better care of your charges. I found this young man running up and down the hallway all alone. We don't want to lose any of our little darlings now, do we?
I'm sorry, Mr. Dobson. It won't happen again. He was only going to the bathroom, sir. Come in. Sally, this is Mr. and Mrs. Wilson. They've come to take you to your new home.
What about me? You can't take my sister away from me. I want to go with my sister. We are still a family.
I'm sorry, young man. This is how it has to be for the moment.
But I have to take care of my sister. I promised.
She'll be in good hands, Jess. Don't worry.
I want to go with my brother.
Look, sweetheart. I wish we could take your brother with us. But if everything turns out okay, we can come back in a few months for your brother.
Oh, honey, don't cry.
I want to go with my brother.
Maybe if we allow Jess to walk his sister downstairs, he'll be a good boy. Right, Jess? Jess?
Sister. Jess, she'll be in good hands.
okay. Now stop it. She'll be all right. Stop it. Say goodbye.
Jess, don't worry. She'll be in good hands.
Jess, stop it. Young man, stop this. She'll be fine. Christ, come back to the office. I'll handle it from here. Please.
Go ahead, patch her through. Hi, honey, what's up?
I've got problems. The Davis kids just ran off. They were last seen on a motorcycle heading towards Farm to Market Road.
Well, that maniac still out on the loose? Okay, I'll put out an APB right away.
Please. Okay.
Thank you.
too, but there's too many people at the house.
I miss Mommy and Daddy.
Me too.
Sally, it's still here.
We're gonna do a little song I wrote a while ago for the Great American Cowboy called Coyote Ways.
Our time. Come on, let's go find the kids. Let's get out of here.
Come quick!
Well, what about Sunday, Kathy?
Yeah, okay. How about 8?
Great. I'll pick you up at 8.
Sheriff, come to dispatch. We have another victim.
I gotta go, honey. Damn.
our dad.
Well, hop in, I'll give you a ride.
Thanks.
So, you're looking for your dad, huh? Where is he?
His plane crashed.
Oh my God.
Yeah, they only found bits and pieces of the plane so far.
I'm really sorry. Hey, listen. I've got to get some gas and stop at the market, but then I'll take you guys wherever you want to go. Okay?
Oh, good. Because I'm hungry and too tired to walk anymore.
Just in, Sheriff Walker of Cascade is asking everyone to be on the lookout for a 12-year-old Caucasian male with brown hair and brown eyes. The boy is accompanied by his 7-year-old sister who has blonde hair and hazel eyes. The pair was last seen on Valley Road. If you have any information on these children, please contact the Cascade Sheriff's Office immediately. Now, here's K&J with Spend All Your Love on Me on KBOI.
Sheriff? Where are the kids at?
I think they're over there by the cookies.
You think? You don't know?
That's where I saw them last.
Okay, we'll take care of them.
Good look around. I hope you never end up in here. Understand?
Kids need some food and medicine. Do you want me to bring you back something, Jake?
No, I'll go along with you. George, come here.
Watch the kids.
Gave me last night, George. I'm not sure this is the county. It's a real borderline. Yeah, what you need to do is check your border markers.
See the kids. They're not in the car.
They're probably with George, honey.
George, where's the kids?
Damn it, Jake!
I'm sorry, Miss Colbert.
Come on, George. Spread out. They can't go far. Just look.
Where are they?
Thank you. By golly, look at this. What do we got here, huh? Old Bart will play with you. He likes little kids. No, no, you don't have to be scared of old Bart. Bart's a good guy. Bart likes little kids. Don't be scared. Come here. Hey, old Bart, you and I can get along and have a good time. Oh, Big Brother's got to be a hero, huh? Okay, little sister, now it's your turn. Come here now.
Go to sleep, Sally.
All right, people, let's listen up. We have to get this search organized. We have to find Sally and Jess. Where was the last sighting?
Jug Handle East.
Well, if the kids are last seen around Jug Handle, maybe they'll be up around Louie Lake. That's good horse country, and I can take a group up there.
All right, we'll take the horses and cover the Louie Lake area.
Where do you want the four-wheel drive rigs to go?
Take the four-wheel drives to Keller Hall, Walker Road, and let's get this show on the road.
All right, let's mount up and disperse.
We'll meet on the east side of Jug Handle.
Howdy, officer.
Hey.
What's going on?
Looking for a couple of young kids, boy and a girl. You haven't seen them, have you?
No.
Made it.
Me too. Let's go down to the river.
Better try fishing.
Got an idea. Come on. These are the children that we saw at the adoption agency.
Yeah, they are.
Those poor darlings. We gotta go out and help find them.
Yeah, we should.
Well, let's go.
Now?
Get your shoes. Tonight? You can drink your coffee later. Come on, let's go.
Do you know how time it is?
Doesn't matter about the time.
Right.
Get your shoes on.
I thought so. Chris, do you smell that?
Something.
Check that out, would you?
Yeah, and on closer examination, they found that it was Jess's knife that killed that maniac.
Yeah. The smoke jumpers will be there. Well, they'll be on call. Thanks, Kurt. I'll meet you at the airport.
Are you ready to go look for the kids?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hit him up, Ford. Here, Ford.
Those poor babies.
It's okay, Mama. There's a reason for everything. Don't worry.
Mr. and Mrs. Brooke, is there any news? How are they?
Do you really care, Miss Colton?
Finders, keepers, Miss Colton.
They have double pneumonia. It's a miracle they're still alive. They can hang on for another 8 hours. We have a chance. So start praying.
I hear the kids are being released today.
You heard right.
Good. I'll arrange for the Wilsons to come in and pick up the little girl and sign the final papers.
Harry, I've made other arrangements.
What other arrangements?
The children will not be separated. I'm giving them to the Bergs. I've already signed them over.
You can't do that, Miss Colter. It's against policy and definitely against regulations.
Here's
give me the file.
Regulations.
I'll revoke it.
You do, Harry, and I'll have the entire news media on your ass.
Hey, you guys are going home today.
Hey, all right. Oh.
That's what we've been waiting to hear.
Nobody's ever going to take you away from your brother or your new family ever again. And these papers finalize it.
Thank you. All right.
See?
You're ours.
You're finally ours.
See the surprise?
All right. You ready to go outside?
Yeah.
Come on, let's go. Woo! Oh, what it is?
All right. I wonder what it is.
What?
We'll be okay, right? You'll always stay with me?
Sure, Sally. You know, I believe Mom and Dad are still taking care of us.